But in all seriousness, I wanted to give you a little intro to the video that you're about to watch about power stealing thermostats and how a half watt 1,000 ohm resistor prevents the, I guess, thermostat from stealing power from the, really? I don't know. Guys, you know, I have been in the trades, you know, technically speaking, since around 2002, right? I grew up with a background, you know, my father was a project manager for commercial building projects, especially with aviation and the Port Authority. So he helped build the JFK Airport, the John F. Kennedy Airport, you know, during the 80s and early 90s expansions. But I was always mechanically inclined. But I've been in the trades, the HVAC and plumbing trades, since, I guess, 2002, right? As, you know, legit, you know, on the job learning with, you know, stuff like that. And I've seen, guys, you will know, if the guys are in the trades, you'll know that when you take open a thermostat box, especially like the Honeywell, the green Honeywell relays, switching relays, you have these little computer chips in there, right? Those resistors is what they're called. And keeping it real, until this episode right now that you're about to watch, I have never had to even do any research on quote-unquote power-stealing thermostats. And why? Because I never ran into it. But ladies and gentlemen, I want to stress the fact that the first time you run into something and you're unsure of that, do your best to absorb as much information about that which you didn't know to help better yourself, right? To help better yourself. Because you need to learn something new every day, okay? So let's sum things up here, and then I'm going to let you roll with the tape. A power-stealing thermostat is sometimes it could be an inexpensive or expensive thermostat. Expensive on that side would be a Nest. Inexpensive would be a cheap Home Depot Honeywell T87F yo-yo imitation, because there's no mercury bulb in there anymore. It's a computer board. But these thermostats contain no batteries, right? So if a thermostat contains no batteries and it has a computer chip in there, how is it getting its power? It's stealing its power from R and W at the zone relay, right? Because you have TT there. One of them is 24 volts. Correct me if I'm wrong, but one of them is 22 volts. And this is, correct me if I'm wrong, this is based on my understanding and based on my level of expertise. But like I said, if I'm saying something wrong, tell me about it. We learn something new every day, and if we can learn from one another, even better. So one of those TTs going to RH and W on the thermostat are giving it 24 volts. The thermostat utilizes the W terminal going back to that TT to act as a common. So when it's stealing power from the thermostat, from the relay, I'm sorry, it's just enough to keep its juices going, you know, like, you know, but it's also when it asks to close the circuit, it doesn't have enough power to close the circuit and change the circuitry at the same time. So you install these resistors and apparently it still gets that small 24 volts, like that, you know, little heartbeat in the background. So apparently it does that. But like I said, I just want to make a quick little intro. A power stealing thermostat is a thermostat that's utilizing, it could be Y if it's a heating only circuit, or it could be W if it's a heating only circuit, and Y if it's just a cooling circuit, you know. But think about it. Where do these thermostats get their power from? And it gets it from the RH or RC and the common. If there's no common there, it'll go back on W or Y. So let's watch this video, guys, and you'll see. First time for everything, and this is one of them. Thanks for watching, guys. Smash that thumbs up in advance. Let's get to the show on the road. Pop quiz, Daniel. What do you know about power stealing thermostats?
I've never heard of it before.
You've never heard of it before?
Never.
Have you ever replaced a Taco switching relay on a boiler?
Yes.
Have you ever read the manual that comes with it?
No.
No? Go get the manual. Okay. All right, so that's Peter, that's Den, right?
Yeah.
So turn it back on. And guys, I'm going to show you power stealing thermostats. So zone 3 is Den. Right? Is it cranked up? Okay. See, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So we have this little resistor here, right? And that gets installed between W and C. In case you don't know what power stealing thermostats are, I'm gonna tell you, right? And it's written here in the instruction sheet. So I'm just gonna read a few, right? And it says, some thermostats are a quote unquote power stealing type, which means they are powered by the switching relay with just two wires, R and W, right? A resistor may be needed in order to have the thermostat work properly. This resistor should be placed between W and C terminals on the switching relay. If the thermostat manufacturer does not supply a resistor, a 1000 ohm half watt resistor has proven to work with most models and is readily available at electrical supply outlets like Radio Shack, which don't exist anymore. Yeah, let me show you.
See? There it is. Feel free to pause. So, Honeywell.
They supply those. We're going to take those and we're going to put them across WC on all these zones. All right, so let me show you what I did here at the Taco SR503 switching relay.
All right, as you can see, I have these little half-watt, 1,000-ohm resistors that came with the Taco SR503 switching relay. So I have one between, on zone one, between W and C, zone two, between W and C, and zone three, between W and C.
And the reason why we are installing these is because this is a power stealing thermostat. It steals power from the relay in order to function. We're gonna reconnect R and W at the base of this other power stealing thermostat. All right, and then we're going to turn it on and see if the zone powers. Okay, she's in place, cranked all the way down. Let's see if the zone turned on. There's the other zone, living room. So now let's do the bedroom. Okay, good. Smash that base, I mean the thermostat onto the base. Just crank it all the way down, good. Okay, crank it up. And click. And now look, all three zones are on. And guess, well, you know what the best part about this is, Peter? I just created an entire separate video than the original one we started on, which is the radiant heat now working in this Taj Mahal in the basement, right? Mm-hmm. But now I just created an entire separate video for content on power stealing thermostats and how to resolve it. Ain't that tits?
Nice. I think it's tits.
It's pretty nice. It's pretty nice. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.
There it is. There's the Taco SR503 switching relay manual, and there's a section for power stealing thermostats. Right? You have these cheap Home Depot thermostats, like that Honeywell Yo-Yo, right? And it doesn't run on batteries. It's utilizing R and W to power its circuitry. And when it does that, it's called power stealing. It's stealing power from R at the relay to power its own circuitry. So when you have that, in this case, in the video I just created, and this is like the cutscene or the end of the video, you have these little resistors, half watt, 1,000 ohm resistors that you put between, on the relay, between terminals W and C. And then the zone will work. But one of the things I do when I come across these shitty thermostats, right, and I just replace the relay, this hundreds of dollar relay, I tell the homeowner, and it's also written on the invoice, that we are not going to guarantee the relay if you're using these shitty thermostats, right? And he's like, all right, whatever, I'll get new ones, da 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 da. I'm like, all right, whatever. I offered him the White Roger Series 80, you know, that we installed, but he didn't want to pay for it. And I said, all right, just, you got to remove the resistors.
That seems so odd that it goes to common, though.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not an electrical engineer, but those guys at Taco know what they're talking about.
Did you notice
the
typo?
Is it a typo?
E.g., ate the batteries. There's an
example.
Eight there for no reason.
Ate the batteries. Oh, Example, the batteries are fresh and installed correctly. See, learn something new every day. Ain't that right?
Cool. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed today's video, I want you to take a hammer and smash that thumbs up button with the freaking hammer. And make sure you hit that subscribe button as well. It motivates me to get more crazy stuff like this going. You hear me? Do it now! Smash it!